Hi, first graders. Today for our nonfiction book, we're going to work on the animal appearance. Well, the appearance of your animal is what your animal looks like. So that's going to be our heading for today. You're going to have a paper that looks like this. It says appearance right at the top for your heading. You have the spot for all of your writing and then the picture at the bottom. These are the questions that we need to think about when describing your animal. One, how big or small is your animal? So when you're describing what your animal looks like, you want to talk about the size of it. Two, what colors are your animal? And three, does it have any special features? So things that make your animal special. So we have a couple of different things we can do. One, we can look at Pebble Go again. Two, we can look at books. So let's start by looking at Pebble Go. If I go to frogs again, at the very top, these look at all your choices. All right, which one did I hit today? Yep, body. Okay, so the body's going to tell me what your animal looks like. It's going to give information about the appearance. So you can listen to it or you can read it. Let's read what it says about the appearance of frogs. Frogs are amphibians. Their wet skin can be many colors. Long back legs make frogs great jumpers. Frogs are between half an inch and 1 foot, which is also 1.3 and 30 centimeters long. So let's talk about what we learned here. You're going to pause the video and you're going to talk to your class or a family member about what you just learned about frogs, because that's going to help you put this information into your own words. Go ahead. Okay, first graders, now that you had a chance to talk about what you learned about frogs, let's look at a couple pages from books, because I feel like I need a little bit more information about frogs. Maybe you have found enough information in Pebble Go for your writing, but maybe you want more. So I found this one book, and on this page it says, most frogs have webbed feet. Some have sticky pads on their feet. So I think it might be really cool to put in some information about webbed feet into my book. Here's another one. Many frogs are brown, others are green, some have bright colors. This is a really cool looking frog. I like this one. All right, so once we start our writing, remember we want to try to take the information that we learned and put it into our own words. So this is what I started with. I started to talk about the colors. So it says, some people think frogs are just green. Frogs can be blue, red, and brown. They have bright colors and spots. So I thought it would be very neat to, I always assume that frogs are green because where we live, that's what we see. But frogs are all different colors. So I thought it'd be a good idea if I really put in there the colors that I just read about. And I also saw in the pictures that they have bright colors and spots. All right, let's see what's going to come next. Special features. So yeah, it talked about the long legs, right, and the webbed feet. I thought that was really good information that I want to put into my book. So I added, frogs have long back legs for hopping and webbed feet for swimming. So now I wrote why they have those long legs and why they have those webbed feet. Last, how big are they? So I didn't put like what it said about the centimeters. I thought that was just too much information. I don't need it. So I wrote, frogs can grow up to 1 foot long. Okay. So when you think about the size of a ruler, that's how big frogs can get. I have never seen a frog that big before, but that's how big they can get. Okay. Last, you're going to work on your picture and you want to draw it like you explained it. So I said that frogs had spots. I said they could be bright colors. I said that they have their long back legs for jumping and their webbed feet for swimming. So I'm trying to get as much of those details as I can into my drawing. And I know you will do the same thing. If you want to go on Pebble Go, you can pause it here because here is your username and your top secret password. Remember, you can also go on Epic, or if you don't have your Chromebook with you, you can look through different books to find information. Remember, look at a table of contents of a book and to look up the body or the word appearance, and it's going to bring you to the page so that you can look through the book and find the information you need for this page. And of course, keep this paper with your other book pages because we're almost ready to put it all together into our nonfiction book. Thank you, first graders.